from a magic show to free ice cream and a teddy bear parade, it's going to be a day full of fun at the Midwest Kid Fest.
Larson, that sounds like heaven to you.
I know. I think I'm skipping work tomorrow and I'm going to this.
Here to tell us more about it is Fargo with the Fargo Park District is Jessica Corinta, also Katie McCormick. To both of you, thanks so much for being here.
Yeah, good morning.
It sounds like a great day. So, in your opinion, what's going to be the highlight tomorrow?
That's hard to say. There's going to be so much exciting things going on, from the entertainment and crafts and the parade. Is something for everybody.
Yeah, there's something from arts to inflatables to petting zoos to all sorts of fun stuff. So there's really a little bit for everybody.
Mm-hmm. And so the Sanford Children's Hospital, that's the people who are also putting this on with you guys, the
yes.
sponsors.
Yeah, they're one of our main sponsors. They have a whole section at the event tomorrow with things to get active and get physical and use your body and
get moving.
Motion. Right, exactly, get moving. Yeah.
So let's talk about this, because this is the 18th year. So what do families really like to come and do?
Well, like we said, there's a little bit for everybody. So the day kicks off with the teddy bear parade in the morning. And what kid doesn't want to be in a parade? So it's an opportunity to bring your favorite stuffed animal. A bear is suggested, but hey, if you have a stuffed dinosaur you really love, you can bring that too. Decorate your stroller, decorate your bike, and come and march in the parade. The only entry fee that we suggest is bringing a non-perishable food item for the Great Plains Food Bank. And that's really the only cost to participating in the parade itself. And then from the parade, we'll march around Island Park right in, and that's what kicks off Midwest Kid Fest. And then there's, like we said, there's inflatable fun, there's art projects with Picasso Point, there are life-size games, and when we say life-size games, we mean giant Jenga, giant checkers,
Connect Four,
that's probably my favorite one to watch, actually. There's parachutes, there's lots of fun games that kids can do and go and be active, and it's all free.
Right.
The other part that's nice is that there are meals available. Mm-hmm. Those would be for purchase, but you could make a day of it. If you don't want to purchase what we have, bring a picnic.
Nice.
And set up and have your own little picnic lunch too.
So. And why is it so important for you guys to be doing this inside of one of the parks here in the area?
It's important for us to really support the youth community in Fargo and give them something to do. And then so many organizations and vendors come to this event to show what they have to support kids in our community. And it's really great for everybody to see that the whole Fargo community supports kids and really building up our youth base in this area.
So what time is the teddy bear parade kick off? And is there like a time frame going on tomorrow? Is it just all day and night? Or
Pretty much. The parade starts officially at 10:30, but you'd want to get there before that to line up, and there's a waiver to sign when you get there. And then after that, once that gets done and into the park, the event runs from 11 to 7 tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
I just think this is something so fun, and it's not just the kids who have fun, but the parents who are watching their kids have fun too.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Parents, grandparents, we have daycares that come too and bring their kids. It's a really great kind of fun vacation day in Fargo. And when we're talking about the community, we have, in addition to all of the things we're putting on, we have 40-plus booths from community members where they're bringing their own hands-on activities and games for kids to do. Mm-hmm. So it's really kind of everybody coming together to celebrate and get out and get active.
Right. And you're saying a lot of those hands-on things, you guys have some examples here. So we'll actually take a quick break, and then when we come back, we'll be talking more about what your kids can do at Midwest Kid Fest.